Hello, my friends. Welcome back to the channel.
Welcome back to the channel. The Pawn Takes Pawn update for day two has happened. A new in-game vehicle has been unlocked. More information in regard to our underground subways has arrived. And this mysterious image right here. Well, it's not so mysterious until you take a look at this character. Who is this? Why does this look like Nikolai? It looks like Nikolai. He drank too much vodka. Is it actually Nikolai? Is this an alternative outfit for Modern Warfare Nikolai? Is this a look into the future on what Cold War characters mixed with Modern Warfare characters are going to look like? Is Season 6 holding a little more detail than we originally thought when it comes to mixing and combining the Warzone experience? Now, obviously, it is rumored that we are going to be getting a zombies mode come October for the Warzone experience. In fact, there's been some stuff data mined from the game that points towards a night version of this mode. So the way that I look at it, it would totally make sense if we saw zombie characters or in some way, shape, or form zombie throwback outfits for our characters in regard to zombies, since it doesn't technically exist in Modern Warfare. But on the other hand, when we think about Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War, and obviously everything that's happened in the past with our main four, Dempsey, Nikolai, Richtofen, and Takeo, the story is done. Well, essentially the story's done. Does it mean they're coming back? I'm just so damn confused. This definitely looks like Nikolai, and I don't think there's an outfit in the game right now that actually looks like this. I mean, I guess there's one that looks similar, but it's not exactly this, and that's for the operator Bale. It's called Sokoli, and this is what it looks like. I think that this is either going to be a Bale operator skin. Maybe it is something for Black Ops Cold War. It is possible that we are seeing some sort of new character model for something that will be part of Black Ops Cold War, or it's like a throwback outfit to remember the past. If that's the case, I'm really hoping that we see more than just this, but obviously, when we're looking at outfits like this, we have to remember that it was at one point an outfit that a soldier would wear back in history. So it's not too far-fetched to just think that it's going to be an operator skin for somebody like Bale. And there's no denying it. Out of every single soldier that's here in the screenshot, and there's a lot of them, that soldier is just so out of place. The outfit looks really, really different compared to everybody else. So I figured I'd bring it up in this video. But yeah. Either it's a Bale skin or it's going to be for the Nikolai character being added in Season 6. Either way, it's really confusing. Let's go ahead, move on, talk a little bit about the subway station because we got a lot of information about that today, including how they work, when they will stop, and of course how you can use the fast travel system as they're calling it. So first things first, all of the subway stations are going to be open. There's a total of 7 of them at the start of every single Warzone map. When you make your way down into the subway itself, you're going to be able to find different loot caches, contracts, and things of that nature, dropped weapons that you'll be able to pick up, just like any other lootable place on the Warzone map. But you're also going to be able to get into the train and take it in one direction or the other. Depending on what platform you're on, the train will take you in that direction, and it will take you to the next station. Now, from what they describe in this blog post, which I will link in the description below, you're going to have to wait until there is no fighting happening either on or around the train for the doors to close and for it to continue. If there's fighting happening, you're going to have to eliminate the threat before the train will get going. But while the train is going, you are completely safe. You cannot be attacked. You cannot be killed. They even describe this as the one true safe area. So use this time to swap weapons with your teammates or reload or do whatever you have to do. They also describe that in every single station, there is going to be some sort of equipment room or break area where there will be an escape hatch that you can climb up out of just in case you get cornered. It will take you out of the subway and back on the ground level of Verdansk. They also mention in this article that if you get caught on the tracks, you're going to be facing imminent death. And if that happens, then your teammates aren't going to be able to pick up anything off of the tracks. So those electrified tracks actually prevent you from going on it. This is actually a little bit of a bummer to me because I imagined in my head that you'd be able to take ATVs down here and try to traverse many ways, but now that I'm looking at how this is handled, this was most likely done to prevent people from actually staying underground when there is a final circle collapse. How many times is a circle going to collapse when you're in the tunnel of a subway? That I don't know. They even mentioned that the subway stations know when there is going to be a circle collapse in that certain area, and the trains will stop running. So It's kind of interesting to see how they're handling it so far. Once we're in-game, then we'll know exactly how it feels. But as of right now, it's sounding pretty promising. This is more or less just a glorified fast travel system with some new subway locations, but otherwise, the tunnels are completely off-limits, it would seem. I would imagine that there's not going to be much to see in the tunnels itself, but this would probably be a good place to add some Easter eggs, so while you're riding the subway, keep an eye out in the tunnels. I'm sure we might see some supernatural things, maybe zombies, maybe, who knows. Now finally, I'd like to talk about the Pawn Takes Pawn Easter egg. Day 2 came and went actually extremely quickly today. I think it was all solved in under an hour, and once again, Geeky Pastimes was at the helm, solving everything and getting everything done while everyone tried to scramble on their terminals. 6 different content creators received Tandy 1000 old school PCs, and these are the keys to unlocking the Easter egg steps. So overall, things have been going pretty swell. Yesterday, Geeky Pastimes discovered that we needed to enter the codes Forceful Gale and Covert Conflagration. Entering these codes would then allow you to get these passwords right here. Now, these needed to be entered in each of the specific color-coded terminals that each one of those content creators had. This then led us to pawntakespawn.com/VCharlie, aka Victor Charlie, and this is describing the first mission from Call of Duty Black Ops 1. Now, once again, just like yesterday, we needed to take the specific images from the Chopper Command game and put them together. We then came up with 6 different codes: Checkpoint, Loadout, Cloud Bounce, Side Quest, Kill Screen, and Cooldown. All of these needed to be entered somewhere. It wasn't until Geeky Pastimes discovered that the Easter egg was similar to the one that we had yesterday, in which we needed to look at the redacted areas of this specific transcript on VCharlie and put together a website URL, which turned out to be pawntakespawn.com/subterranean-signal. Once you get to this, there are 6 different locations to enter codes, and that's where you enter Checkpoint, Loadout, Cloud Bounce, Side Quest, Kill Screen, and Cooldown. Upon clicking that, you are then rewarded with a code that you can actually put onto your account, and this code unlocks this particular Tactical Rover right here. Although it's not actually unlocked for me in game just yet, it has applied to my account and it's applying towards everybody else's account as well. Since this, we've also gotten 2 different maps and a letter from someone by the name of Tatiana. All of this is coming together very smoothly, if I do say so myself. But once again, if you'd like to get yourself a free Tactical Rover skin, and this is exclusive to doing this particular Pawn Takes Pawn step, just go to pawntakespawn.com/subterranean-signal and enter the codes Checkpoint, Loadout, Cloud Bounce, Side Quest, Kill Screen, and Cooldown, and then you'll be rewarded with your free Tactical Rover. Anyway, guys, that is it for this video here today. Let me know what y'all think about it down below in the comments section. If you enjoyed the video here today, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live, and you'll be part of the notification squad. Alrighty, folks, I will catch you on the next video. Let's see where day 3 of Pawn Takes Pawn takes us tomorrow, and I'll see you then. Peace.